Hi, in this video I'm gonna show and tell you a little bit about the Tusk Orc mask before you decide to buy it. So this mask is inspired by World of Warcraft and the Warhammer universe, and because of the dimensions of this mask you will never be able to expect your eye sockets and the space from your mouth to fit exactly over your head. Because the eyes and the mouth piece is so far apart, you will always have your mouth a little bit higher inside the mask than that of the actual mouth. So the size of this mask is for young people or older children in the age of 12 to 14, depending on the head size. My head is 58 centimeters in circumference, if I measure it from my temples and all the way around my forehead. And for this mask to fit, your head should be between 52 to 54. So when you buy this mask, inside you will find that it actually has some foam inlays. And it will have a foam inlay in the forehead, which is right there, and then two in the cheeks and one in the chin. So what I would suggest, and that would not void the warranty, is to peel out the foam in the forehead and try the mask on. It could be an idea to have this piece of foam then glued in to the neck, or first try it at least to see how the mask is centered when you wear the mask. So use this foam to adjust the mask accordingly to fit your head. So for my head, it's a bit too small. But I'll try to put it on and wear it to show you guys what it looks like once you're wearing it. Here goes. Okay. So when you're wearing a mask like this, for me, it's a little bit too tight. And if I were to use this mask, I would have to accept that it's not super comfortable. And I would also have to cut out a piece of the eye sockets from the inside here to actually not have it stick into my eyes. But a face and the shape of your eyes and how it's formed is very different from person to person. So for someone, it wouldn't be a problem, but for some, you would need to get a scissor and cut that part out. So just keep in mind that if you start modifying the mask to your head, you're not able to return the mask once you start cutting and tearing it. But it is necessary if you want this mask to fit you well. So once you receive the mask, you see that inside the forehead, you have a foam block placed right over the eyes, and you tear that out by just tearing it as close as you can to the latex. And once it's removed, there will be some foam left of the gluing, but that doesn't really matter. Now, the second thing you want to do is adjust the eye sockets. If you see here, there is quite a lot of excess latex here, and for some, it wouldn't be a problem, but for others, would need to cut out that to have more space. And you can do that by either using a scissor or a side cutter, and just take small bits of that latex
Don't take too much. Better take a little bit too less and then try it on for size and see how it works. And then once that is done, then again, you try it on for size and see how it fits to your eyes. And as I said before, you can also use a scissor, but it does have to be a quite sharp one in order for you to be able to cut the latex, because the latex is a fairly resistant material. Once that is done, you try it on for size again, and you see now the cavities are a bit smaller. And looking from the outside, as long as you have part of the latex going into your eyes, you're actually able to cut a piece of that latex away as well. And if the mask is to look properly, then you would also, you know, put some dark paint around your eyes when you wear it and around your mouth.
So that's all. And if you have any questions in regards of fitting this mask, or if it fits to your size, don't hesitate to write us and we'll help you as well as we can. Thank you for watching.